Coach, coming off the big win last week, both sides have postseason aspirations on the line. What was the mindset coming into this game and also just overall thoughts of getting the win?
Yeah, I thought it was a really good response, again, from our guys. I think they were fired up to play. They knew that building off of last week's momentum was the defense convincing fashion, and obviously they carried it forward today. They played really, really well on the defense side of the ball, and the offense picked it up, from the beginning through the game. I just think you could see the momentum really switching over, and the second half in particular in that fourth quarter was really great to see us put together and finish off the game the way we wanted to for a big win at home.
Speaking of momentum, you get that touchdown at the buzzer at the end of the first half, and then you answer with their touchdown at the start of the second half. How important was killing, RPI's momentum as well?
I think it's crucial. I mean, it was two good teams going at it, and I think anytime you face two good teams, momentum is a huge swing. So whether that was, there was a couple of situations either where you got a short field or something that helped switch the momentum, but they had two relatively big plays, like quick, big hitters. And I thought that was a great response from both the special teams and the offense to be able to come back and answer it. So they never felt like they could really extend it past the two-possession lead. And then same thing, we cut it back to the one possession and then eventually took the lead. And then thus pumping it up to the two-possession, thought that was really crucial for our defense because it changed. I think they were doing a good job shutting down the run anyways, but it kind of almost forced them to be one-dimensional with the pass. And I think that helped, and they had some good players and got some yards passing it, but I think it was really helpful that we kind of shut down their run and made them more one-dimensional.
What can you add about that defense, especially, RPI going up by 11 points in the second half early and giving your offense allowed to make this comeback?
Yeah, I'm just really proud. I think we always talk about our response to adversity, and you're playing a good team, and all of a sudden there's twice where they put it to that two-possession game. I thought the poise and just the cohesiveness on the sideline, I didn't see anyone flinch. We talk about champions don't flinch, and I thought our guys did a pretty good job, riding that and then finding, like, we looked at each other in the eye and said, someone's going to have to make a play to change that momentum, and it doesn't need to be a big play. If you look at it on offense, it was more drives than big plays. The time of possession, the physicality, the O-line, the tight ends, the running backs, everyone up front, and we talked about it. I think that was a really crucial part of it was winning the line of scrimmage, and it was closer even in the first part of the game, and then I think as we got more and more plays off, and I think the confidence of the guys started to grow, and then we were able to run the ball even more in the second half, and then, like I said, taking it from the two possession game, chipping it down to the one, and then when we finally took the lead, you could just tell the defense was they were hungry to take the field, and I think they saw that we could have a chance to really put RPI away, and we did that in the fourth quarter.
Another senior day for you. What can you say about this year's senior group?
Senior day is always bittersweet. I love our seniors. Every year it's tough saying goodbye to people that you spent, 4 or 5 years plus with. By the time you think about the recruiting process and some of these families, think of a guy like Joe McCoy, whose brother played for us. We know these families for many, many years. We talked about trying not to make it be about their last. Yes, this is their last regular season. Hopefully, maybe we put ourselves in a position where we might be considered for a home, postseason game. Who knows? But we're gonna have a chance to honor them after the season. But I was really just proud of these guys. From day one when they came in, you got great men of character on and off the field. You got great students. You got great, obviously, players as talented, and they're all uniquely different. And I think that's the toughest part. I'm gonna be upset and in a good way of like, you don't want to say goodbye to these guys. So we're just gonna try to keep these guys as long as possible in terms of keeping the season going. When the time's right afterwards, we're just gonna be able to really look them in the eye and thank them for all that they've done on and off the field as student athletes, as citizens on this campus, and really just representing the football family in a great way.
What are you looking to accomplish in the regular season finale next week?
It's a big one. For us, they've had a bye week for us, so they'll have 2 weeks. So I know they'll be fresh and ready to go, and they played pretty well this year. So I know it's going to be a tough one for us. We'll enjoy this one now, but we're going to get back to work, late tonight, early in the morning, and then be ready to meet with the guys tomorrow. But our goal, we talked about it, is controlling our controllables and what we can do, and that's the only thing we have guaranteed right now is one more game. We're going to put all of our focus in and hopefully finishing off the season on a strong note, and then if everything goes well, maybe earning an opportunity to play another one.
Thanks, Coach.
All right. Thank you.